Hi, my name is Mike Hoffman, Product Marketing Engineer with Agilent Technologies. In this video, we will compare the Agilent 4000X series and the Tektronix 4000B oscilloscopes. We'll look at usability, update rate, memory, and triggering. Let's begin. Let's look at the Agilent 4000X series. First, let's maximize the use of the scope's 8-bit digitizer. 8 bits translates to 256 discrete voltage levels on screen, so for the highest signal resolution, you'll want to use all of them. If you find yourself stuck between scales, Agilent offers a fine mode, which is enabled by simply pressing on the vertical control knob. You can also use the same fine mode feature to change the time base by pressing the horizontal control knob. In fact, all knobs have a second function when pressed. The text below the knob will tell you what the secondary function is. To learn more about any knob, button, or soft key, press and hold for 2 seconds to access built-in help information. Tektronix does not offer a quick way to switch and define vertical mode. You must navigate a few menus and then use a tandem of knobs to center the waveform on the display. Additionally, Tektronix does not have a fine mode on the time base. It also lacks pushable knobs and only offers limited built-in help functionality. Next, let's look at the importance of update rate. We've connected the trigger outboard of each scope to a frequency counter. You can see Agilent is updating at 613,000 waveform updates per second. Tektronix is updating at 63,000 waveform updates per second. As you enable digital channels and serial decode on the Agilent scope, its update rate is not greatly affected. This is due to our patented MegaZoom 4 ASIC that does digital acquisition and serial decode in hardware. Now let's look at the Tektronix scope. As we enable digital channels in a serial bus, notice how the glitches and jitter have basically disappeared. The update rate has dropped significantly to just 30 waveform updates per second. This is because the Tektronix architecture relies on a processor to handle digital acquisition and serial decode, while the decode itself happens in software. These extra features should help you find problems, not hide them. To learn more about capturing glitches using fast update rate, watch our extended video, or download our Oscilloscope Waveform Update Rate application note for more detailed analysis. Next, let's compare the memory architectures of each scope. The Tektronix 4000B can optionally have up to 5 times deeper memory than the Agilent 4000X series, but deeper memory is not always better. Tektronix defaults their memory depth to just 10,000 points, and it must be adjusted manually by the user because of the trade-off between memory depth and update rate. InfiniVision scopes handle memory depth automatically to keep performance high. Additionally, Agilent uses smart memory technology to capture only information you're looking for and ignore relevant data in between. We call this segmented memory, which is not offered in the Tektronix 4000B. Learn more about segmented memory in our segmented memory video. Finally, let's look at triggering. In this complex signal, it would prove difficult to isolate a particular edge using traditional methods. But with our InfiniScan Zone Touch trigger, we can simply draw a box around an edge of interest and select Zone 1 Must Intersect to isolate it. No other scope in this class offers this feature. They require you to use advanced triggering. While it is possible to accomplish the same results that way, InfiniScan Zone is much simpler. This trigger method, when paired with a very fast update rate, makes isolating glitches very simple, and you do not need to spend time remembering advanced triggering methods. You can watch the extended video on InfiniScan Zone triggering or read more on our application note for more information. To learn more about Agilent's 4000X series oscilloscopes, please contact an authorized distribution partner or visit our website above. Thank you for watching.